Hello, I'm Il Sirwin, and welcome back to the Red Strings Club.
Let's do this.
Okay. So you already know who it was.
Fuck.
Well, that's my job. I called you hoping you could tell me something I don't know. What do you know then?
She was killed!
Eh. Why was she killed? She infiltrated a private clinic that literally advertises its deadly security measures.
Okay.
Supercontinent ought to protect their clients while they're vulnerable. What did she expect? There wasn't any other way to disable her except killing her. Their security AI judged her a critical menace to patients' well-being. I work on the security system myself. Trust me, I didn't witness it, okay? But I'm sure it was justified.
Why do I feel like you're lying to me? Aha!
Yes, why do you say that? Adrian's death was too convenient to be just that, part of a security protocol? I'm not lying to you, Donovan. I programmed the system myself. The only condition that allows execution is when a client's life is in danger. I agree that it's too convenient for Supercontinent, but what do you want me to tell you? Okay, oh fuck, I screwed up! I am not getting anything from this! Fuck it, we'll worry about this one. I'm worried about something. Do you mind if we invert roles for a moment and you listen to my problems? Okay. I wouldn't miss a chance to learn more about the mysterious bartender. Fucking hell. Thanks? See, this is about Brandius.
Who? He got into trouble again?
Who the fuck's Brandius? Was he the guy who was playing piano? Because I would not pay attention to his name. He's always in trouble, but that's not what worries me.
I should have served her fear drink, shit!
Agity, you act moody, depressed, sometimes even aggressive. Oh yeah, that is strange. A guy with so many implants as him, I guess he'd have some stress regulators. All of that's making him more and more reckless. I'm afraid one day it'll come to the worst. Hey Donovan, it's really weird to see you show concern so openly.
Yes.
So this must be grave.
Indeed it is.
Listen, Don, don't worry. I'm really surprised that Brandius is acting that way. But my work will soon make everything alright.
Your work?
What are you working in? Count this as my payment for the job I want you to do. And please keep this information as confidential as possible.
Okay? You realize you're too after your information, broker.
I'm dead serious here. If this leaks to the wrong ears, I could be in danger.
Fuck.
Don't sell it cheap, at least. Don't worry, I'm very aware of what information can do. I'll keep you safe.
Okay.
Brandius' personality issues will be totally solved. Spall is taking care of everything.
Oh fuck, I should have- Oh no, I'm screwing this up!
Do you mean social psyche welfare? Shit, Donovan, you already know about that?
Yeah!
Yeah, I do. Who the fuck is leaking this info? I don't think it leaked, I'm just, you know, too good an informant dealer. I'm probably the only one who knows outside of Supercontinental LTD.
I'm gonna get it- Dude, that's gonna get you a hit squad!
So you got it from someone on the inside? No, you know, I've never really revealed my sources. That's also why you're safe talking with me. Okay, so if you already know about the project, you know you can rest assured.
Okay! That's bad! I should've...
I'm not very aware of the details. Is it safe? Fine, I can fill you in. I'm the director after...
Okay, this is bad! I'm gonna get you killed, I'm sorry.
You've got nothing to fear.
Okay, how about I switch tactics? Let me just try to, your paranoia here. Yes, let me play into your fears real quick.
Okay. Thank you, are we done? Fear seems to have taken hold of her.
Okay, here, psych-
Tell me more about social psyche warfare. Do we have to actually discuss it? You've already discovered I'm the director, so what else do you need? Just tell me a bit about what it actually is.
My life could be endangered. Oh, my, I screwed up! Damn it! Is there not any? Is there not anything else I could tell you about? Just not that, please. Oh, fuck. Okay, serve another drink. Okay, I screwed up.
How you like that drink, huh?
Ah, so good. Okay, you're calm. Okay. I was trying to pronounce it. I don't know why. I guess there's no way back with you now. There's no way back with you now, so I'm going all in. Are you ready? Yep. Shoot. Social psyche welfare is the greatest revolution in the area of human comforts. We've been working for a long time on designing a system that keeps the user at their best. Wait, what? We're working for a long time on designing a system that always keeps the user at their best. Why can't I read? Spirit is able to tell apart feelings like depression, anxiety, rage, and keep them in check using only the power of your own physiology. It's all natural, no secondary effects. Get information about well, I guess we're doing this now. Won't Spirit make you stop being you? It's not going to affect individuality at all. You sure? It's only natural to be scared at the prospect of unlimited happiness. Okay? But this is less intrusive than the average antidepressant the city's inhabitants swallow every day. So you're saying that removing an important part of our mood spectrum isn't going to change our personalities? I didn't say that. It will help us access our better selves. Okay? Or do you enjoy being sad? Yeah, I wouldn't like to lose my sadness. Yeah, what he said. Why not? Sadness is not ugly, Diana. I've been bartending for a couple of decades now. I've gotten to witness innumerable forms of sadness right here where you're sitting. Right there where you're sitting. And it can be a beautiful thing. It's moving, it draws us all together, keeps us thinking, wishing. So you're actively working to suppress it. Just feels like a crime against humanity to me. Wow, I'm not ready to debate such poetry. Give it some thought, please. Okay, I will Oh, I made her doubt herself! Interesting! What the hell is this?! Oh no, what is this?! It's an anxiety! You installed the hippie okay. Oh no, is this all gonna come back to bite me? Oh no! Oh no! There's things in here that's gonna come back to bite me! Is this gonna affect creativity? Yeah, I hope so. Why is the volume so low? Excuse me? One second, adjusting the volume for me. Okay, close enough. Depression as a source of inspiration isn't just an unhealthy myth. What? Maslow's pyramid, baby! To achieve self-realization, to fully embrace creativity, you first have to be at peace. Okay. You don't have to be depressed to write a dark tale. Yes, you do. That's where the feelings come from. You don't have to hate to draw violence. You kind of have to. Art is emotion through the filter of calm focus. Yeah, but then you're just going to draw like a plain rock. Okay, but what experience is the artist supposed to distill if they haven't felt anything before? Ah! Oh, but haven't we all felt enough already? There's so much left to feel, yeah! Don't be a hypocrite, there's so much left to feel! Don't be a hypocrite. I'm sorry, I didn't see that letter. And for what? Just to suffer? You're saying that it's it's justified to let people in pain just in case they're potentially artists? Okay, I think I screwed up. That's a ridiculous oversimplification. We know sweet because we know sour. We know good because we know evil. Removing one side of life's duality deprives the other of meaning. Okay, why is this philosophical now? In your accidental way of life, maybe. Okay, but the most zen way to go is to reject dualism altogether. Okay, there's no being sad or being happy, there's just being. I see. Spirit grants the completeness of a Zen master without the
Accessitis. I can't read that. Now you're just bullshitting. Now you're just bullshitting me. That's honestly my stance. But I guess we'll need a couple of extra nights for me to fill you in on Zen philosophy. Oh, what the hell is... What is this? Or at least a part of if that's convenient for your brainwashing brochure. What? Okay, easy now. Do you want to know more about Spoo, or have you unwound enough... mind control, yes. Yeah, I'm just stretching this out, dude. That's quite a stretch. Isn't unhappiness what drives us forward? What you're selling sounds like the most kind of conformism. Worst kind of I can't say shit. No one will ever be willing to fight, to rebel, to disrupt our world. That's pretty convenient for corps and governments all alike, isn't it? The fine prince of eternal happiness is absolute obedience. Don't exaggerate. I am using Spur right now. Do you see me? Wait, what? It's harmless. Do you see me as a harmless lamb? To be fair, we do know each other, so... There's no reason for you to try and kill me, you know? I don't think so. How can you know? I feel better than ever. Okay... See, you're wrong about unhappiness being the greatest motivator. Isn't it? The best goals are born from joy and love. Yeah, but like, others can be born from depression. I can't name a few, but it happens. I don't blame you, you've always been a survivor. But those days are almost over. I don't want to sound delusional here, but... Spirit is fucking worldwide peace, can't you see it? Excuse me, but no, I can't see it. Yeah, I mean, so we have a positive side and potentially a negative side. The world needs disagreement to keep evolving. World peace just means eternal slumber. Let me stop you right there before you start making a plea for war. You know, that's not what I mean. Isn't it? Only that you just said world peace is bad for humanity. I mean, stagnation versus, you know, evolution, so... Okay, this argument is going anywhere. Let's change the subject to what is a bit of an... Don't you think it's all a bit of... Fucking hell, dude! Don't you think it's all a bit unnatural? There. Yeah. Oh, now you're talking like an old-timer. Oh, fuck you. Do you know how many times that argument has been wielded against progress? The evolution... I gotta be careful now, because I know my choices can screw me over.
Like and subscribe!